Hello there, and welcome back to Let's Play Two Worlds 2. I'm the RNGenius, but you may call me Eric, and in the last episode, we went to the burned-out house, and we got the inkwell out of it. We also got a skill book there for a ranger skill. We could look at that right now. What does that ranger skill even do? It was precision shot. Ranger precision increases damage dealt in sniper mode. That would be very good if I used... Man, bow fighting is also very cool in this game. No, I'm not gonna replay this though, it's a huge game. I've decided to go into magic and I will go into magic. Apart from going there, we also went into this horse riding competition. We had to try it two times because it's actually quite rough. The timing is quite close. You don't have much. You cannot get thrown off your horse, and you especially cannot go in there and saying, "Oh God, the timer is already running. Where do I have to go? Where do I have to go?" And go into this direction. Oh, wrong direction, and turn around. That we didn't have the time for that. We didn't have that kind of luxury. So we had to try two times. We won. We got a skill point for it. And turns out there is a thing like horse community, horse riding community type reputation. It's, if you look at this, my reputation went up by 10. You know your way around a saddle. Combat stats, you give me that. Lockpick 70 out of 100. That's what I get skill points for. That's what I get those skill points for. For alchemy performed 2, metallurgy performed. Ah, the next time in 30 locks I pick, I get another skill point, and then it's gonna be higher than that. And monsters and enemies killed, it's gonna... That's cool. That's very interesting. Metallurgy performed. Thefts. Yeah, I'll go into... when I learn how to steal, I will definitely steal from people. But these don't count toward it. Only those do. Arena. Horse races for the for these you also get skill points, so you get a lot of skill points. The Thieves Guild, Merchants Guild. Jesus, this is gonna be a huge game. This is gonna be a huge Let's Play.
What are you doing here? Are you giving up?
I've beaten you, just as you asked.
I'm sorry. But I can't allow my people to be led by someone so irresponsible. I'd rather die.
I'm not gonna fight you, Alton.
I'm not giving you a choice.
I'm not gonna kill you.
You're going to have to.
You'll resume trading with Alima and her people, and you'll be compensated accordingly. As long as you do this, you can continue leading your people.
Our supplies are minimal at best, because of our limited access to a cheap source of fresh water.
Now you're talking like a competent leader. If there's a water source in the area, I'll find it.
That would be great.
But in return, Hallhin needs to resume trading with Bayan. Do we have an agreement?
Yes, I think so. I don't believe you can find a solution, but maybe I'm wrong.
You are. We'll talk later.
Wait a moment. I'll open the village gate just in case. Don't be surprised if you're not welcomed with open arms.
Why not? I was already in there.
The majority of Hallhin doesn't take kindly to outsiders.
Well, they wanted to trade with me. Although they did remove that forging station that I most certainly saw. Thank you for opening that gate. Do I have that weapon equipped? No, that's sheathed. Do you have anything new in stock, sir? Ooh.
Hey.
Yes, you do. Senior Necro Staff. Decay. Poison. That's some serious gear you're packing there, my friend. Is he listed as a trader on the map? Bazan Drought. And no, he is not. Well, there is a little symbol here, but I don't think he... Hallhin. That's the village. And you were called Drought? No, you were called Drew, weren't you? I don't remember. I don't care either, though. So, what to do next? There's a dude, but I remember him not wanting to talk to me. I'll go back to Bayan and actually look at what the store dude has. Like, the store owner. Because the things you can pick up at stores change very regularly. I remember him selling a Ricochet carrier card, and then suddenly he wasn't selling it anymore. Well, let's go back here, teleport to Bayan. Because if he sells something even more interesting than that, I might as well pick it up. If he is... It's nighttime, I see. So this affects you guys.
Hey, wait a minute!
And you are?
My name is Flora. I used to be a scribe's wife. We divorced 3 weeks ago.
And?
And I truly, truly hate him. I heard you decided to fetch that damn inkwell of his.
Sounds like you have some resentment for him.
Not so much him as I do his ridiculous inkwell. I hate it! I hate everything about it! I spent our entire marriage washing the ink stains out of countless linens. I swear he loved that thing more than me.
Then it's a good thing you divorced.
To say the least. I assume you're working for my ex-husband, because you need a writ of protection to pass through the gate.
That could be the case. Why do you ask?
My ex-husband is slipping in his old age. His last client was flagged at the gates. The guards chopped his hands clean off as punishment for providing false documents. I have a better proposition. Give me the inkwell and tell that old mule you couldn't find it. As payment, I'll show you the old smuggler's passage to Hatmandor.
I didn't like the scribe very much. He sounded just like an old drunk.
I like my hands, and I like your offer. Take the inkwell. What do I care?
You're a wise man. Wiser than my former husband, anyway. As promised, I'll mark the entrance to the old smuggler's passage. But be careful. It's been ages since anyone has used it, and there are plenty of widows who can tell you why.
You know... In that passage, there is most likely loot. That's why I decided to do that. The smuggler might be in his damn own house. So I might as well go in here right now. Are you in here? You know.
Pleasure to see you again, son. Any news on the inkwell?
It seems everything was lost in the fire.
That's disheartening, to say the least. I had hoped it had stayed protected in that old chest, but I suppose the fire was just too much for it.
It seems that way.
I apologize for sending you all that way for nothing, but my skills are useless without the proper equipment. The most skilled hands in all of Antaloor couldn't get through those gates without the Imperial Crimson Ink.
I'm sure I'll figure something out.
Well, good luck to you, son.
Thome bought it. What do you say? He's unhappy.
I think I'm just going to burn this damn inkwell and send the ashes to Thome.
Huh. And now I have the passage marked on my map, don't I? It's right there. I'm gonna check that out right now. Just because I can.
Looks like you're lost.
I'm
just
not.
Trying to get to Hatmandor.
That's no easy feat. especially with the increased patrols guarding the gate. But there's always another way.
Yeah, now that I know of it.
What might that be?
It's an old one. Used to be for smuggling goods to avoid the heavy import.
Why do you tell me this now?
Nobody much uses it now. Seeing as we barely have enough to support ourselves, let alone trade. In fact, I'm one of the last people who even knows where it is.
Can't imagine you'd like to share that information.
Yes. I'd even be willing to take you there. For a price, of course.
Thanks, but no thanks.
How much are we talking about?
300 ores should do it. I usually ask 500, but you seem like a nice enough guy.
I have heard that story.
300 ores for information isn't exactly what I had in mind.
If you find a better deal, by all means, let me know.
Yes,
yes. I'll be here if you change your mind.
You'll be here. I'll remember. Thank you. Have I never gone out this way before? I mustn't have. No, yes, I definitely did go. Because there's the gravedigger. Hmm. What is this area anyways? I have not explored anything in this area. Have I? Let's see where I'm going. No, it's here. That's all unexplored territory. Intriguing. That's the old smuggler's passage back here. If you had not done that quest, this gate would probably be closed shut. That's nice. But I do wonder about that. I do wonder.
Let's get this over with.
Varns? Is that you are a mage? Oh god darn it. I forgot. I forgot that Varns are completely resistant against shock. And this is an air staff. This is a fire staff, although I'm just gonna switch out that air for fire now. Okay, stop hitting my ass. You're just standing there. You cannot go through the gate. Please tell me you cannot. Please tell me this is not really why. Man, this game sometimes. Nothing good here. Although that cross wooden shield could have a thingy in it. I don't see anything. Remember when I wanted to go back to the village to just check out the store? That was times. Good times. Why can you shoot through there and I can't? Come on around. Let's do a little bit of shooting practice. You can also stand there if you want. I don't mind. As long as your shots don't hit. That sounds dangerous, sir. I know my own weakness as a mage, so let's just exploit his same weakness. Skill crystal. What's that do? Skill crystal. Elemental resistance. Nice. These are ceilings. We got an earth staff out of that, most likely. That's fire. Pretty good. No, he was using a necro staff? That's odd. That is odd indeed. I also got an amulet out of it, but that's not worth much. Okay, I didn't see that fight coming either. Let's open that chest and continue onwards. Another spell amulet. I'm probably gonna have to sell one of those at some point. Just because those are not that valuable. Is that a water pot? No, that's just a totem. Oculus Draconis, don't need that Oculus. What's going on here? You're standing, but there is no way I can backstab you, my friend. Around this way, what's going on here? You are, I don't even want to know what that is about. And that should be the end of the passage. And not any more enemies around here, are there? Oh, yes. There is a couple of cheetahs. So I guess I now know why there's no, like, widows going through here. And, that's what a couple of widows can talk to you about. That the smugglers died here. Ah, now I get it. That was hard. I'm not that smart a man, aren't I? I mean, I shot him, but does it? Yeah, it goes right through his head.
This should be fun.
I thought one aggroed. You said this would be fun. There. Stop it! Ow, 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 ow! You're blocking. Well, have fun doing that. Combat is not as easy as it looks. Man, fighting these is... Come on, you just go ahead attack. I charge up my fireball and I... God damn it, how can you hit behind yourself? I thought I already was sneaky enough. There you go. Took a hell of a lot of damage, a lot more than I was supposed to. Nothing good out of it, just stuff that crowds my inventory. Okay, those were the only two here. There's a chest. Not particularly interesting. Are you... I'm not gonna even talk about that. And yes, I just walked through the fire. There you are. Two should be enough. If I hit. And I did hit. The other one aggroed as well. No. The other one is stuck in the rock. Of course you are. I really do love this. I really do love that AI. Well, a fireball blasted him out of it. Where's the other one? That's good. Alright, let's sheath that weapon and continue onwards. Don't even know why I'm clearing this. What are you? There is something. Ah, just a warthog. That should have been a hit. Thank you. Hey! All right. It's good that I put a point into that resilience stat. Thus, my health is constantly just regenerating. I don't even have to use any healing potions. Got over the gate, but there is still a dude. Here. Aye. Talk about it. Nice. So if I want to get back over to this side of the gate, Can I just come through here? Or do I have to activate a teleport? Nope, it's just locked. That's the bad thing about the Smuggler's Pass, that you cannot just walk in and out of that gate anymore. But if there's a teleport out here, we can just deal with that. Man, the land does not look good on this side. Now I know what they're talking about when they say a drought hit the place. Jeez, this looks bad. There's nothing going on here. Except for a chest. Chest is going on. I like that. I like that. Four layers go that side. That's good. Go there, there. There and there. Yep. Easy enough. There's a dude running. I'm gonna catch up to you. What do you mean I didn't take all of it? I don't care anymore. I saw you. Where were you going? And who the hell are you to run away? Stop. Stop, sir. Sir. You're a guard. You are, in fact, a guard.
Stop. Identify yourself.
I'm just a traveler on his way to Hatmandor.
No. No. You're too well armed.
Last time I checked, Gandohar hadn't outlawed weapons or armor.
You have to be with them. Why else would you be carrying such heavy equipment through the desert?
Them? What the hell are you talking about?
The Varns who attacked my battalion and overtook our blockade. I'm the only one who's left.
Do I look like a wolf?
Varns or no Varns, I'm getting to Hatmandor.
There's no way you can take them all on. That's suicide.
Ian the coward, huh?
You're crazy.
You want a health potion or something? I don't have any more. That's nice. So, do we want to tell him about that whole village of Varns that I, like, obliterated? Probably not. He's going to feel bad about himself. He's probably going to feel bad about himself if I do that. Let us actually go to the shopkeeper and, of course, go to this equipment set, because otherwise I'm just going to go ahead and sell all the stuff I own. Shopkeeper.
You look like a man who knows what he wants.
Those boots are not worth much. Before I sell those boots, I might as well just break them down. The hats, too. Not like I wear those Voyager armor. I get two leather and fabric out of that. I get fabric out of this. Improved acolyte air brim. I'm already wearing that, yeah. So I can break this down for one fabric. Casting boots. What are casting boots? I wonder about that, I really do. Anything else I want to break down? I think not. What I do want to do is upgrade these pants or that. Or the boots. No, I'm thinking upgrade these. This armor. Because I get 2% blunt weapon protection out of it. Eh. I could not care less. I'll just do that. I can do it again. Yeah. Now that would have surprised me if I could have done it again. Upgrade that too. And anything else I can upgrade? Yes, but if I... Nope, don't need to take out the torch in broad daylight. Okay, that's what I have equipped. This is something I will never need. So I'll just go ahead and sell that. Sell these for 65. These robes are worth. Like, I'm not going to need an acolyte robe here. I'm not going to need an initiate earth robe. Although... why is that one blue? Is this already upgraded or something? No, actually this initiate earth or this initiate water robe is better. I can't just use that if I get water mastery level 3. I'm ways away from that, so I might as well sell this thing. Also this. I guess I'm just awaiting to get, I have to think about what I'm selling here, because you saw what I did. I saw my, I sold my goddamn chest piece last time. I can get rid of that too. Not gonna get rid of that. I'm just waiting for an air rope to come by. No. I've got this razor sharp Gladys equipped. Grisile cutlass, might as well sell that because I cannot equip it. Go. Keep. Go. 100 or a necro element. And I'd rather have the 100 gold because I don't need to upgrade any necro staffs anytime soon. Do I have anything here I want to upgrade? I have 10,000 gold. Thank you very much. 1,500 for a personal teleporter. What do you give me for parasite eggs? Those were quite easy to harvest. Oh. And for a spell amulet? 80. Yeah, right.
See you next time.
All right. No, I cannot end the episode right here. Gold ring with inlaid stone. That's actually quite good, but nope. Not selling that. Anything good here? Is that a katana? Yes, it is. That's a really cool looking spear. There's no need to invest in one of these. That's a missile carrier card. Time modifier. Give me one of those. Give me one of those. Thank you. Violin. Music. You're still... talented tongue? Yeah, I'd like that too. No, you don't have the spell artisanry anymore. I'm gonna come across that. I don't need to invest in a skill book and later on just get it. It's basically like a waste of 12,000 gold in my opinion. And even despite that not actually being the case, I cannot do that. Am I investing in a time modifier? I don't know what it does. I guess I am. I don't have one yet. What do you have?
I appreciate
vases.
The business.
Of course you have vases. Why do I even ask the vases salesman if he has anything but vases? Is that a Tonto? Whoa. Slim? No. No need. Okay, why did I buy the missile carrier? Mainly because now I'm just gonna go ahead and put an air element here and a missile carrier here. I can put that in there. No, I don't have one of those anymore. I already have that on this. Oh, I'm just gonna go ahead and have a missile carrier here. Because I'm getting rid of these. And I'm just gonna put it here. Missile carrier, you have the death. And I cannot put a time modifier on any of these. Oh, I only have one homing spell. I only have one homing modifier, so this is not homing. Dang it, that's not working out how I wanted it to. Psyche, frost damage, creates an area of effect. It's not a... is that a viable spell? Yeah, frost damage in an area of effect. That's okay for the moment. If I take away this damage modifier, do I... Effect duration is increased by 5%. Eh. Oh. Modifies effect, giving it protective properties. Oh. I see. That gives you now additional elemental resistance too. Nice. Can I put a second damage modifier on this? No. Might as well put it here then. That's a thing I cannot do anymore. Now it's protective. Uh-huh. Wait, does it actually have... Does it say what it does now? Target has 30% chance of being unable to attack, lasts 5.2 seconds, range 4 meters. Costs 200 mana. Well, there's a damage modifier. Well, we'll have to play around with that a lot. For the moment, I hope you enjoyed it. I will save, and I hope I'll see you in the next episode as well. Until then, bye-bye.